Hey guys, I'm Sunita and in this video I'll talk about this beautiful indoor plant, fiddle leaf fig plant, also known as Ficus lyrata. The common name of this plant, fiddle leaf fig, comes from the fact that leaves are the size and shape of a fiddle. This plant is native to the rainforest of Western and Central Africa. Despite its popularity, it's certainly not the easiest houseplant to look after. But when proper care is given, its visual impact in space is incomparable. Fiddle leaf fig cherish warm, humid environment, a fair amount of water, and plenty of lights. Choose a location away from air vents and drafts where this plant will receive plenty of bright ambient light. If you are unsure about your lighting conditions, placing this plant directly next to the window is the safest bet. Always put a sheer curtain to ensure that the plant doesn't get direct light. This plant should get around 5 to 6 hours of bright indirect light and humid environment to keep it at its best. Rotate your tree once a month to keep it standing straight and tall. Fiddle leaf fig in particular like to reach towards the light. So if you don't rotate, you will notice them bending over time. Fiddle leaf fig plant are particularly sensitive to environment changes. They will likely to take a little time to adjust to their new home. Be sure you follow the care instructions when you bring this plant to your house. The fiddle leaf fig gets killed due to overwatering or not allowing for proper drainage. Water your plant about once a week or every 10 days. This plant likes its soil to be kept evenly moist with a brief drying out periods between waterings, as it comes from an area of the world that gets very dry between rainstorms. Water it thoroughly whenever the top 2-inch soil has dried. Never allow the soil to dry deep to the lower root system, as it will lead to leaf loss. The best way to obtain accurate moisture reading throughout the soil is with a soil probe. It will allow you to check your plant's moisture level at the root level. If it is showing the plant is wet, then wait for it to dry and then water. Water your plant when the meter reads almost dry. Every 3 months, rinse your plant's leaves with room temperature water. This helps remove any dust that gets accumulated and also ensures they are able to absorb and photosynthesize sunlight more effectively. You can fertilize this plant once in a month with organic houseplant fertilizer from spring through fall. Generally, after buying from the nursery, your plant should not need any fertilizer for first 5 to 6 months. Fiddle leaf figs are decently happy as root bound plants and will do just fine in the pot you bought it in. Just place it inside a large decorative container or basket and don't go for repotting after bringing it to your home from nursery. For larger floor plants, you can do repotting every 18 to 24 months. Typically, you should choose a pot 2 to 4 inch larger in diameter to allow for growth. You should not choose a pot much larger than the previous one, as this could drown the plant's roots. If you prefer to maintain the current size of your plant, repot into the same pot, providing new soil and trimming away some roots and foliage. Spring or summer is the ideal time to repot, as the plant is at its strongest. This plant may get attacked through spider mites, mealybugs, fungus, gnats. The first warning sign of spider mites is webbing. In case you see even a hint of webbing, like thin silky strands inspect the leaves carefully for insects. The web is the number one indication of the presence of spider mites. The appearance of small clustered dots on the leaves of your plant confirm spider mites attack on your plant. The good news is that you can easily dislodge these insects from your plant. Fill a kitchen syringe or misting bottle with water and spray the little dark dots until you don't see them anymore. Spider mites are one of the most common threat to the beautiful Ficus lyrata. So always stay vigilant. The next most common fiddle leaf fig pest is the mealybug. First, let us discuss how to identify this pest. Mealybugs always find their way into your home through other plants. They secrete a wet-looking substance called honeydew, and the female mealybugs produce a cottony material to lay their eggs. If no white bugs are visible, then simply keep an eye out for a cottony substance or a wet-looking residue. You can use the same method to get rid of mealybugs as well. However, you may see their recurrence. You can use rubbing alcohol to get rid of these pests. Dab each little mealybug and cotton nest with a drop of rubbing alcohol to neutralize the bugs. You can also use neem oil spray to get rid of these pests. Take 2-3 ml of neem oil and mix it in 1 liter of water and do the spray. Gnats are another common nuisance associated with indoor plants. However, fiddle leaf fig favors conditions that are not conducive to fungus gnats. So if you do have gnats, your plant is likely in a darker place with too much water. Keep your fiddle leaf fig in a bright place and use well-draining, loosely packed soil. These measures alone should prevent gnats population. You can prune your fiddle leaf fig plant during spring or early summer. Always keep the shape you want to give in your mind and then prune the plant. You can give it a bush shape or a tree shape. Always sterilize your instrument properly before you start pruning. Also cover the floor with a sheet, as after cutting, this plant releases a sticky sap which may spoil the floor and also irritate the skin. You can mark branches you want to prune by putting small colored tape. It helps to make sure the leftover foliage looks balanced. Never remove more than 10% of your plant at once to reduce the risk of shock. You can propagate this plant through stem cutting. You can take a branch about 3 inch below the first leaf. Always choose a few of the healthiest leaves on your plant to take for your cutting. Use a clean sharp tool to take your cutting. Dip your stem in rooting hormone and then place it in water or soil. Use filtered or chlorine free water for propagation. Place your rooting system in a bright place without direct sunlight and check it every few days to ensure it has enough water and light. Replace the water with clean, chlorine-free water at room temperature if it looks dirty or cloudy. The root should start coming in 1 month time. This is all about fiddle leaf fig plant. For more information, I have given few links below. Please go through these. If you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.